My name's Moira Salt, and I started in the NHS on the 4th of March 1974. I first started in the NHS to do my training, my mental health training, at St Edward's Hospital in Cheddleton. It's no longer there, sadly. It was the old Victorian asylum hospital, which moved at the turn of the last century up to Newcastle. The Equal Opportunities Act, the Equal Pay Act, still hadn't quite been enforced, so I was paid less than my male counterparts at that time until Barbara Castle got a grip, and then we got equal pay. But yes, that was 1974. I remember moving into the nurse's home on the Sunday, my mum in buckets and buckets of tears, because she was leaving me in this awful place. It wasn't very well decorated, the nurse's home, I have to say. And I always remember when you closed the curtains, the dust and everything. And of course, my mum was horrified. But I was so excited. This was a big adventure. I was leaving home. I was starting my training. So yes, I can remember feeling really excited. The first day meeting your colleagues, there was still a lot of the old attitudes. There was still a lot of the old semantics around it, really. A lot of the old terms were still bandied about, which I think they've gone into obsolescence now. But yes, I think things have changed quite a lot over the time that I've spent in the NHS with regards to, you know, attitudes towards mental health. From early years, you know, when I joined, it was the teachers. There was John Hazelhurst, who the Hazelhurst unit at the Harplands is named after. He was a very kind, very, very kind guy who was a wonderful teacher, very humane man. And then there was JJ Leonard, who was the other, he was a senior teacher. And he was, oh, he was a big Irish guy who was hilarious. I don't think he meant to be half the time, but he was. So from my student days, that they would stand. There was some families and generations of families who had worked there. So yes, you get to know the family, and yeah. There were some real sort of nice, genuine, you know, good people. I've been able to have a career and a family, and, you know, sort of it's worked around that really well. I think that's one of the great things, that it's there and will accommodate you. And I have been lucky that I've been well accommodated to, you know, live a life alongside my work life. So, yeah, I think there's not many professions where that works for you quite so well, I don't think. Congratulations to all my colleagues in the NHS that have achieved 45 years work within the NHS.